It's Cat Country 107.3, Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Welcome to a Tuesday morning.
Good morning.
It is the 30th and final day of April. It's Adopt-A-Shelter Pet Day, Honesty Day, Mr. Potato Head Day. Do kids even play Mr. Potato Head anymore?
I don't know, but I always wanted the lady and I never got her.
It's Oatmeal Cookie Day and Raisin Day.
Ugh. Do you like Raisinettes? I might be judging. I may or may not be judging.
I like raisins. I like raisins. That's I like fine. Oatmeal cookies.
I like raisins in like trail mix. Maybe a cinnamon raisin bagel. But never in a million years would I be like, you know what I really want right now? A box of raisins. No, that wouldn't be what I say.
Coming up at 8:20 today, your first of five chances to win that fabulous trip for two to Phoenix to see Luke Combs. That's coming up at 8:20. Or you chaperone some school trips. What's the worst school trip you ever went on as a student or a chaperone? That's the Joe and Jahna question of the day today. We have some rather amazing answers. Why did you guys go there? We'll talk about it at 7:20 this morning. In the meantime, we'd love to hear your story. You can answer us on the Cat Country 107.3 app or hit the message us button or call us at 609-383-1073. The strangest, scariest, worst field trip you ever went on. Good morning. We're Joe and Jahna. Here are three things you need to know this morning. The FAA Tech Center is staying in the Atlantic City area forever. Congressman Jeff Van Drew says legislation will keep the center at the Atlantic City Airport permanently. In addition, the facility is getting a new name. It'll be called the FAA William J. Hughes Center for Advanced Aerospace.
North Wildwood is going to receive state help in dropping the erosion of its beaches. Mayor Patrick Rosanello says Governor Phil Murphy has allocated state funds for an emergency replenishment of the community's beaches. The beach is a major economic driver for the community during summer, but coastal erosion has reduced the beachfront from 36 blocks to 26 blocks. Mayor Rosanello says he expects the project to wrap up in time for the height of the tourist season, the 4th of July.
Shocking story from up in Essex County this morning. The mother of an elementary school student has filed a lawsuit against Verona Public Schools, alleging her daughter was sexually molested by a classmate at school. According to the lawsuit, the girl was 6 and 7 years old when her male classmate would enter the bathroom and crawl into a stall to molest her. The lawsuit says the assault happened more than 20 times over a period of several years. The suit claims the girl told a teacher about the assaults, but the instructor did not believe her and actually made her apologize to her male classmate. The district is investigating the charges. South Jersey weather, partly sunny and 78 today. We want to send you to see Luke Combs in Phoenix. Details in less than 20 minutes. Cat Country 107.3. Tyler Hubbard, it's Cat Country 107.3. Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time now for Jahna's Fangirl Update.
This year's ACM Awards, they are coming up fast, man. They're going out on May 16th. Reba is hosting this year. Can't wait. She's going to be performing, too. Country music's last two entertainers of the year lead the lineup of the 2024 ACM Award performers. Five of the seven nominees for the 2024 ACM Entertainer of the Year are set to take the stage. We've got Jason Aldean, Thomas Rhett, and Miranda Lambert. They're going to perform. So will Lainey Wilson, Jelly Roll, Chris Stapleton, and more. We've got the complete list up for you right now at catcountry1073.com. Make sure you check it out. It's going to be a great show. You're going to love it. Lainey Wilson and Jelly Roll, they're each other's biggest fans. They always have each other's backs. They're never afraid to sing each other's praises, that's for sure. That's what Lainey did when she talked about Jelly Roll's work ethic. So she said in a recent interview that if anybody works as hard as she does, it's Jelly Roll. He had commented on how he hasn't seen anybody work as hard as Lainey. So she turned the tables around on him and said that if she had to name anybody as her second, it would be Jelly Roll. We've got Lainey's response to Jelly Roll's compliments. They're up for you now on the Cat Country 107.3 app. That's Jahna's Fangirl Update on Cat Country.
We're about a month away from hurricane season, believe it or not.
I know. I can't believe it's already here.
And will there be a Hurricane Jahna this year? No.
Of course not. Maybe one day.
They're out with a list of names for the hurricanes this year. They'll start with Alberto Burl, B-E-R-Y-L.
Burl? Hurricane Burl?
Chris?
They won't do a Jahna, but they'll do a Burl.
Chris, Debbie, Ernesto, Francine, Gordon, Helene, Isaac, Joyce.
We already had an Isaac, didn't we?
Yeah, but apparently it wasn't big enough to cross Joe and Jahna. Jahna, does it bother you that with your cell phone, somebody could be tracking you at every minute?
Yes, it does. Like, somebody I don't know, but like...
Well, apparently they
I'm
have...
I'm happy that I can watch, like, where my mom is because she's older, if that makes sense.
They have been tracking you. The Federal Communications Commission has fined the major cell phone companies a combined $200 million for sharing your location information without your consent.
I'm not surprised. Where's the class action? Sign me up.
Well, that's $200 million. So congratulations to Verizon for tracking me to every pickleball court, golf course, and ice cream place in South Country. 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time now for your Cat Country Joke of the Morning. PJ lives in Northfield and sent us the joke we're going to use today.
Thanks, PJ.
PJ.
Oh, PJ. I messed up. Sorry, PJ. Forgive me, please.
George was 70 years old, went for his annual physical. All of his test results came back normal. Dr. Smith said, George, everything looks pretty good. How are you doing mentally and emotionally? Are you at peace with yourself? Do you have a good relationship with God? George said, God and me are real tight. He knows I have poor eyesight, so he's fixed it. So when I get up in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom, poof, the light comes on when I pee. And then poof, the light goes off when I'm done. Wow, said the doctor, that's incredible. A little later in the day, Dr. Smith called George's wife, Thelma. Thelma, George is just fine. Physically, he's great, but I had a call because I'm aware of his relationship, or I'm in awe of his relationship with God. Is it true he gets up during the night and poof, the light goes on in the bathroom, and then poof, it goes off when he's done? Thelma says, that old fool, he's peeing in the refrigerator again. Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Good morning. Coming up at 7:20, our Joe and Jahna question of the day today. What's the worst field trip you've ever been on, either as a student or as a chaperone?
I really need teachers to comment on this because... Like, teachers, they have to do this. You think teachers really want to go do that? No. No. And I know there are teachers out there. We should say that if you want to contribute, you can remain anonymous.
Did you ever...
Like, you can ask, you can let us know that you prefer to remain anonymous.
You lived in... You grew up where? In Woodbury?
Did you
ever, like, go to the beach or a boardwalk for a school trip? Something like that?
No, but we went to Storybook Land.
That's pretty nice.
Yeah.
That's a nice trip.
That was fun.
No
beach.
Worst field trip you've ever been on, either as a student or as a parent chaperone. Let us know. 609-383-1073 or hit the message us button on the Cat Country 107.3 app. We'll talk more coming up at 7. Cat Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time now for your Cat Country Dumb Story of the Morning. This morning we go to England. A woman walked into a bank, flashed a knife, and demanded cash. Before she got her money, her phone rang. She decided it would be a good idea then and there to answer it. She got involved in the conversation and kind of walked around the bank. Police showed up at the scene.
That's interesting.
Bank tellers pointed her out. She was easily arrested while still on the phone.
That's different.
Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Big Cat Country, congratulations to Matt McAllister. Matt, the winner of Cash Cow. $30,000 top prize. Congratulations to Matt and all of our dozens of other cash winners. We'll bring Cash Cow back again before you know it. Good morning. We're three things you need to know this morning. One person was killed in a single car crash. It happened on Route 30 in Absecon Sunday night. When police arrived on the scene, they found a car off the road in flames. Police say 33-year-old Craig G. Doka of Oak Ridge, New Jersey, died in the crash.
North Wildwood is going to receive state help in stopping the erosion of its beaches. Mayor Patrick Rosanello says Governor Phil Murphy has allocated state funds for an emergency replenishment of the community's beaches. That's good news. The beach is a major economic driver for the community during the summer, but coastal erosion has reduced the beachfront from 36 blocks to 26 blocks. Mayor Rosanello says he expects the project to wrap up in time for the height of the tourist season, the 4th of July. Yay!
The FAA Tech Center is staying in the Atlantic City area, apparently forever. Congressman Jeff Van Drew says legislation will keep the center at the Atlantic City Airport permanently. In addition, the facility is getting a new name, the FAA William J. Hughes Center for Advanced Aerospace. Cat Country weather, partly sunny and nice again today with a high of 78. We want to send you to see Luke Combs in Phoenix. Details on how to win the trip in less than 20 minutes. It's Cat Country 107.3. Line up. It's birthday time. Cat Country morning birthday shout-out start right now.
All right, let's do it.
Happy birthday, Nikki from West Creek. Nikki is 42. Jessica Karanji of Galloway is 39. Jason Goldfarb of Absecon is 41. Happy birthday, Jason. Happy birthday to Joe Ritchie of Heislerville. Joe is 40.
Happy birthday.
Tom Kim has a birthday today, as does Grace Tweed. April Skill of Delhaven is 56. Linwood Chatton of Tuckahoe is 54. Kelly Young of Elmer celebrates today. Happy birthday, Kelly Young. That's it. We missed you. Happy one to you as well. The recipient of our Cat Country big birthday shout-out today, Jessica Karanji of Galloway. Woo! Beautiful day again across South Jersey.
It
sunshine
really is.
78 today. Congratulations, Matt McAllister, Cash Cow winner. And coming up in 15 minutes, morning trivia, Kenny Chesney tickets for his Philly show up for grabs.
That's such a good prize. Dang.
All right, let's get to our Joe and Jahna question of the day today. We've had some interesting reactions so far. We want to know, What's the worst field trip you've ever been on, either as a student or a chaperone? 609-383-1073 or hit the message us button on the Cat Country 107.3 app.
That's so funny.
Did you have any bad ones?
I wouldn't say bad.
Well, that would be the question. We don't want to know about the good ones. We just want to know about the bad ones.
But I would say... like...
Okay, it's 37 seconds has gone by since I asked you the question, and you still haven't answered. Do you have an answer for the question?
Yeah. So
please tell it. Please say it now.
It's just funny because if you have to wait.
Oh, my God, another 37 seconds as it's gone by, and she still hasn't answered the question.
They normally wait until it's, like, warm out to go, right?
What's the answer, Jahna?
It was really bad. It was really hot, and a kid passed out on the battleship New Jersey.
Okay.
This girl passed out, and she ruined it for all of us.
Oh, boy.
And it was annoying. And the worst part of it was this kid that I liked back in the day was the one that helped her.
Uh-huh.
And I was so upset.
You were so jealous.
And it ruined my whole day.
Huh.
Yeah.
All right. That's a wonderful story.
It ruined
story.
My whole day. And so that wasn't a fun
Somebody
trip.
Remind me, and I'd ask Battleship Jahna these New questions Jersey. In the future. All right.
But it was so hot. It was hot on that show. It was like 80 degrees outside, so it was really hot.
So what is the worst field trip you've ever been on, either as a parent or chaperone? Skip says...
smelled weird.
He went to the Barnegat Senior League baseball field. He said, actually, at the time, it was a gravel pit. Before games, we used to go around and pick up stones each game.
And throw them at each other?
I think, to clean it up.
Oh.
I think they were the cheap labor.
That makes sense.
Courtney said, went to the Sight and Sound Theater in Pennsylvania back in elementary school.
I love that place.
They had animals at the time, and I just remember a camel and a horse pooping in the aisle next to us.
That's
and
funny.
To top it off, the play was just okay. It was during Christmas time. She says, smells you would never forget.
I love that place. I was there last year.
On the field trip?
Not on the field trip, but they don't... there's still animals. There's a bunch of them, but okay.
They're not
I remember.
In the house.
I would go as a kid too to that place. They're not on stage as long, and they learn their lesson. Right. So yeah.
Shannon Blair said, speaking of stinks, the ACUA wastewater treatment plant.
Why would you ever bring kids?
I don't
there?
Know. This is what happens when you go to the bathroom.
See, and I thought mine was bad. That's not from a girl passing out and smelling on the ship and all the things. That's really bad.
Roxanne lives in Ocean City. Where'd you go, Roxanne?
So I went to Ocean City High School, and our senior field trip, they took us to the water park in Ocean City that was two blocks down the street from our school. other field trips, like other classes, had gotten to go to like Six Flags, and other places like that. But we got to go to our own water park.
Did you even take a bus or just walk down the street?
No, they probably walked on the boardwalk.
No, we walked down the boardwalk.
Yeah. Oh man, that is kind of a bummer.
For me, I was on work release, so I got to leave at 11:40.
Half your life. You struggle, half your life you fly, half your life making trouble, half your life making it right. One day I'm the exception, most days I'm just like most. Some days I'm headed in the right direction, and some days I ain't even close. I'm a little bit steady, but still a little bit rolling stone. I'm a little bit heaven, but still a little bit flesh and bone. Little foul, little don't know where I am. I'm a little bit holy water, but still a little bit burning man. Burning man. Yeah, I always love the highway. I just don't run. Don't get it as wrong. I still go a little bit crazy sometimes, yeah, but now I don't stay near as long. I'm a little bit steady, but still a little bit rolling stone. I'm a little bit heaven, but still a little bit flesh and bone. Little foul, little don't know where I am. I'm a little bit holy.
3 mornings with Joe and John. Our question of the day today, we're talking about the school field trips. You can call us at 609-383-1073 or hit us up on the Cat Country 107.3 app at the Message Us button. What's the worst field trip as a student or a chaperone that you ever went on? You have one there?
We do, yes. Somebody messaged us on the app. It's Montana. She said, the weirdest field trip I ever went on was to a cemetery to see where the founder of Lakehurst was buried. Lakehurst and Jay.
Hey, kids, you're going to love this.
That's weird. Now, what I think would be cool is to take a group of classmates to, like, the somewhere in, like, Port Republic, like, the Jersey Devil history, the cemetery over there where, like, a lot of the leads are buried, where, like, the legend is that, like, you know, the mom was buried.
Why do you think kids would enjoy a cemetery?
I think, like, middle school kids would think it's creepy and cool. I will, or that's just me. I would have thought it was cool. But I don't know. A random cemetery like that, that's like, I guess they do it when they take kids to go see, like, where Alexander Hamilton is buried at that cemetery right outside of New York City in Jersey.
That one. You went there too?
Yeah, we've gone there before.
Crazy.
But, like, we went, because we did, like, the whole Ellis Island, like, all that. Yeah.
Liz says, as a chaperone of eighth graders, it was New York City. She said, I hated it because I was terrified of losing a student. I had to keep counting heads all day. Joe and Jahna Cat Country Morning Trivia is on the air. Phone number 609-383-1073. Or you can hit the call us button on the Cat Country 107.3 prize. On the app. The prize is 2 tickets to see Kenny Chesney.
That's such a good one. We're on fire with what we're giving away lately.
He's gonna be at Lincoln Financial Field in Philly Saturday, June 8th, 8 p.m. One big show.
Yeah.
You'll have 2 tickets to the big show if you win trivia this morning. Again, 609-383-1073. We caution that you not have won anything from the last 30 days in order to win this morning.
Yeah, you can't do that. These are expansive.
We've asked this before, but we're gonna ask it again. One of these is touched about 25 times before you buy it.
I don't remember. I gave you my answer, and you said it was wrong. So about, clearly, I don't remember.
About 25 other people touched this before you buy it. Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Cat Country Morning Trivia on the air. We got a great prize this week. 2 tickets to see Kenny Chesney. He's going to be at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. Saturday, June 8th at 8 p.m. Tickets on sale, by the way, at LincolnFinancialField.com. Here's the question this morning. It's estimated that 25 people will touch this before you buy it. And we're not talking about people in the distribution process. We're talking about other potential customers. What are people putting their grubby hands on that you will buy?
That's disgusting.
Yeah, I'm not. I'm just.
I know you're just the messenger, but ew.
609-383-1073. Let's go to the phones. What will people touch?
Ew.
25 times before you buy it. Hi, Cat Country.
Hey, good morning. Bag of chips?
No, that's not it. Thank you. Good morning, Cat Country.
Hello?
Hi, what's your answer?
Apple?
Apple is not it. Thank you.
I hope not.
Don't touch my food.
Well, that's why you wash
it. Hi, Cat Country. What's your answer?
Is it a greeting card?
Yes, it is. You're our winner.
Ooh.
Who's this?
Laura.
Hi, Laura. Where are you from?
From Manhattan.
Who else is there with you, Laura?
My husband and my kids.
Are you taking your husband to Kenny Chesney?
Problem. So I was a young father. Lion King, I must have seen the video, the VHS copy. We must have played it 8,000 times when my daughter was young.
Same.
And now comes Lion King, the prequel.
I'm so excited. It's all over the internet, and I can't wait for it. And it gets even better, because you know who's involved with it this time?
Mufasa?
Lin-Manuel Miranda. He writes all the awesome, like, he wrote Moana.
It doesn't matter to
me. He wrote Hamilton.
That doesn't mean anything to me.
Oh, it's going to be so good. And if he's writing the music, it's going to be fantastic.
It doesn't matter.
Yes, it does.
It doesn't matter to me.
Well, that's a shame.
Mufasa, the Lion King prequel, scheduled to come out, I don't know when, December 20th.
I'll be there.
So we'll see if people go back to movie theaters then.
I'll go see it.
Morning, we're Joe and John. You know this morning, the FAA Tech Center is staying in the Atlantic City area forever. Congressman Jeff Van Drew says legislation will keep the center at the Atlantic City Airport permanently. In addition, the facility is getting a new name. It'll be called the FAA William J. Hughes Center for Advanced Aerospace.
North Wildwood is going to receive state help in dropping the erosion of its beaches. Mayor Patrick Rosanello says Governor Phil Murphy has allocated state funds for an emergency replenishment of the community's beaches. The beach is a major economic driver for the community during summer, but coastal erosion has reduced the beachfront from 36 blocks to 26 blocks. Mayor Rosanello says he expects the project to wrap up in time for the height of the tourist season, the 4th of July.
Shocking story from up in Essex County this morning. The mother of an elementary school student has filed a lawsuit against Verona Public Schools, alleging her daughter was sexually molested by a classmate at school. According to the lawsuit, the girl was 6 and 7 years old when her male classmate would enter the bathroom and crawl into a stall to molest her. The lawsuit says the assault happened more than 20 times over a period of several years. The suit claims the girl told a teacher about the assaults, but the instructor did not believe her and actually made her apologize to her male classmate. The district is investigating the charges. South Jersey weather, partly sunny and 78 today. We want to send you to see Luke Combs in Phoenix. Details in less than 20 minutes. Cat Country 107.3. Cat Country 107.3. Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time now for my favorite tweets from the last 24 hours.
All right, let's do it.
There are 5 of them. Number one, I loved being a waitress when people would say my compliments to the chef, and I'd be like, well, that's Kevin reheating pre-made burritos in the microwave, but I'll tell the Toshiba you said hi.
Yeah, right?
Number two.
That's just Kevin.
I've killed every plant I've ever owned, but sure, I'll babysat your kids for the weekend.
Sure, it'll be fine.
Number three, my inspirational quote is, I hate everyone.
Love that journey for you.
Tweet number four. Am I getting older or is it grocery store music getting better?
Exactly. Yeah.
Number five.
And it's real.
My junk drawer is like a museum of things I thought I'd need someday.
You will need that random piece. Well, yes.
It's Cat Country 107.3 Mornings with Joe and Jahna. Here we go. It's time for your code to win this fabulous trip we have for you. We'd love to send you to Phoenix, Arizona to see Luke Combs in concert. Airfare, hotel, $500 cash, concert tickets all included for you and your guest. What you need to do to win is to listen 5 times every day for the Luke Combs code. When you get the code, go to the Cat Country 107.3 app, pop it open, hit the button there that says Luke Combs, and type in the code.
It's easy.
Code's coming your way at 8:20 a.m. and 10:20 a.m. and in the afternoon at 1:20 and 4:20. And then Evan on Taste of Country Nights has the 5th code a little after 7 o'clock. When you get a code, again, go to the app, open it up, type in the code, and you're on your way. First code of the day today is 331.
331. You're going to click on the Luke Combs button. It's right there on the app in the center. You're going to type in 331, and that's going to get you on a plane to Phoenix, Arizona.
3 mornings with Joe and Jahna. Time for another edition of Which Came First.
Okay.
Jahna, I have 4 different things. You have to tell us in each pair which came first. I don't think you're going to get all 4 right.
Okay.
Okay.
Thanks for the faith. I appreciate it.
$1 million is at stake. If you get all 4 right, you win $1 million.
Yeah.
Which came first, the first subway system or the first bicycle?
Bicycle.
Only by 2 years, 1861 to 1863.
Yeah.
Which came first, the Egg McMuffin or Eggo Waffles?
Eggo Waffles.
1960s, Egg McMuffin, 1972.
Yes.
2 for 2. Which came first, the GPS watch or the calculator watch?
Or the calculator watch.
Hmm.
The GPS watch?
Oh, I'm sorry. The GPS watch has been around since 2001.
Uh-huh.
By the way, before that, we'd had no idea what GPS even was. The calculator watch dates back to the 1970s.
What the heck's a calculator watch?
You had a calculator on your watch.
I never had a watch. I didn't even know that was a thing. So that's why I said GPS watch, because I thought...
So you've lost $1 million.
On the, I thought it was just like on your Apple Watch, the calculator.
No, you've lost $1 million. Last one, number four. This is going to be tough. Which came first, Applebee's or Olive Garden?
Oh, that is hard. Is it a trick question?
No, it's not.
Applebee's or Olive Garden? I'm going to say, eating good in the neighborhood.
Which came first?
I'm going to say Olive Garden.
Olive Garden began in 1982. Applebee's began in 1982.